Hello guys, I hope you are doing well and reading also. How is your classes going on? Your college classes? Hello guys, I hope you are doing well and reading also. Yes.
Sir, it's fitting, sir. It's echoing.
Yeah, no, it won't, I think. Then what about your studies? Doing well?
Yes, sir.
Okay. As Dave is telling, yes, sir, we are reading great. Your classes are going on, right? Some of you, the college classes have been going on, online classes.
That's all, sir.
What?
I mean, online class, they are all completed, sir.
Okay. How is your teaching in your institute or in your college? Teaching is good, the faculty?
Moderate, sir. Depends on staffs.
Depends on subject. What about the floriculture? They teach good?
No, sir. Depends on staffs.
Okay. Yeah. How is the floriculture staff then?
Sir, in Annamalai University, that's actually a coastal area, sir. Then there won't be any practical classes also, sir. So the only theory is available, sir.
Okay. Difficult. In theory, if we teach 1,000 times, now, yeah, we will learn somewhat. But if we see, if we do, if we have the first-hand experience or the practical experience, if you incorporate your theoretical knowledge into the practical, like doing in your own campus or doing some small assignments during your practical classes, growing some flower crops or fruits, vegetables, grafting, budding, or any other techniques, if you do in your practical classes, then you will come to know, oh, this is the scope of horticulture. This is how the people will do and make the money. This practical knowledge is very important. So try to learn where at all it's possible by seeing others, by following the farmers' techniques. You can Google it. Now the YouTube is there. There are many other ways to learn. Okay. Then coming to our today's session. Today we'll discuss on another important floriculture crop, that is marigold. Marigold is one of the important floriculture crop. Okay, with respect to India, it is one of the important loose flower. It's also considered as one of the important commercial flower. Remember, this is a commercial flower. Among the loose flowers, there are only few that ranks in the commercial position. Among that, the marigold is one of the important and leading one. I hope the voice is clear and the screen is visible now.
Yes, sir.
Okay, then we'll continue. Coming to the botanical names for the African marigold, the Tegetus erecta. For the French marigold, Tegetus petula. I think you have been reading the marigold crop since from your 3 to 4 years, or you have been revising your this crop thousands of times. So in this class, we'll keenly observe which are the important points with respect to your competitive exam, like JRF or SRF. I won't deal with the production aspect, then other breeding aspect. I won't deal with the theoretical part. I will mainly mention which are the bullet points, or I will mention some of the important concepts where you need to give a stress so that it will help in your competitive exams. Okay. You remember, this is the important annual flower, and it is also considered as a commercial crop because it's grown in a wide range for the loose flower, for the extraction of pharmaceutical products, for the oleoresin, for the essential oil, for many other commercial value. We are cultivating the marigold. We'll deal in detail. Okay. Why this is gaining more popularity? Because it is very easy to cultivate and it has a wider adaptability. This is very important. Easy to cultivate and it can adapt in all the climatic conditions, and short duration crop. Within 3 months, you can expect the yield. Then it has a wide spectrum of color, shape, size, and this is very important. Good keeping quality. It has a very good keeping quality and short duration. Hence, this marigold is accepted as a commercial crop by the farmers. This is with respect to the farmers. The farmers are immensely growing the marigold for the advantage of these points. Then, these scented flowers are hermaphrodite in nature. Both male and female organs are presented in each flowers. Then it is commercially cultivated in Maharashtra, Karnataka, Gujarat, Andhra Pradesh, Tamil Nadu, Madhya Pradesh. In southern part of India, this marigold is very commercially cultivated. Then coming to taxonomy. This belongs to genus Taygetus. And the family, what is the family of marigold?
Asteraceae.
This calendula is one of the subfamily under the Asteraceae. This is a subfamily, not the family. Asteraceae is a family. Then we'll see some of the history. During the past age, during the American Civil War, the First World War, the marigold is used to treat the wounds, to prevent the wounds becoming infected with the toxins or bacteria. So this marigold used as a antiseptics. This is important. In American World War, First World War, marigold used as a antiseptic. You can expect in multiple choice question or in the assertion or reasoning type question or in the mind the following. The marigold is associated with the American Civil War or World War, First World War, to treat the wounds. And further, this marigold is used for making the garland. Then used for extraction of oil, then cream. This oil and cream has the used in the aromatherapy or the skin treatment. This is very important. Aromatherapy and skin treatment. This oil and cream is used. Then for decorating the religious places. Then the leaves of the flowers also used as salad. These are edible flowers. Then yellow dye is extracted from the flower by boiling. This burning of these herbs repels the insect and fly, especially the mosquitoes. Then pigments in marigold mainly extracted for the food coloring, for the edible purpose, or for the livestock, mainly for the poultry, to enhance the yolk color and the flesh color. You remember this one. This is very important. This pigment is mainly used for coloring the food, then for the livestock, mainly in poultry, and soaps also been prepared out of it. Then marigold tea is also one of the a unique product. Then essential oil also there. This is the main business in southern part of India, peninsular part of India. These are marigold gardens, garlands. Then this is the Ayurvedic cream made out of marigold flower, used in many ritual places to decorate the many ritual places. Then this is the lutein, xanthophyll. Marigold soap used from the petals. This is essential oil. This is tea, marigold tea. Then we will see some of the other names. Marigold also termed as Kalta Genda in northern parts of India. Then Haldi Gold, Pot Marigold, these are all the vernacular names. These are all very important. Then coming to the origin of marigold. The marigold belongs to Central or Southern America, especially Mexico. Originated from Mexico. Then this tagetes given, this what it means? Tagetes means a demon god, known for its beauty. It's a demon god. This marigold is termed as a friendship flower in United States. Have you seen the marigold growing in the wild? No, but one valley is there in India, Ranthambore National Park. Here the marigolds are grown wildly or under the natural condition. You remember this one. Ranthambore National Park is associated with the marigold crop. Then coming to botany, it's a hermaphrodite in nature. Then two types of flowers are there, ray florets and disc florets. This is the seed of marigold. This is the disc florets. Central florets will be disc florets. The outer will be ray florets. This will be pistillate flowers, female flowers. This is hermaphrodite flowers. The individual seeds are called akene. This is receptacle. Then coming to types, are the important varieties. Usually the cultivated types are in India mainly African and French marigold. Coming to African marigold in detail, African marigold, Tagetes erecta, it's a hardy in nature, annual, grows up to 90 centimeter. It's tall in nature. It grows erect and it is branched in nature. Then leaves are pinnately divided. Then the flowers are single to fully double flowers and globular heads. Here the flower size will be large. Then the flower color, usually the lemon yellow or yellow or golden yellow. The self incompatibility is present in French marigold and it is cross pollinated and proto anti in nature. Due to self incompatibility and proto anti, it is marigold is highly cross pollinated in nature. And one more thing is, it is genetically male sterile. GMS is observed in marigold. This is African marigold. The flower size will be large. Then French marigold, Tagetes petula. Here, this is also hardy, but the plant height will be 30 centimeter. Only 30 centimeter. Then it is bushy in nature. Compared to African, it will be tall and erect. Then how to identify the African from French? Here the foliages are very dark in green and reddish stem is there in French marigold. This is the main physical character. This is how we differentiate the French marigold and African marigold. This is also one of the important points. The reddish stem and green leaves are the distinctive character of French marigold. Then further, here also the flowers will, here the flowers are very small in nature compared to African. Here the color will be yellow or mahogany red. This type of flowers, these small flowers and yellow to mahogany red flowers will be French in type. Then Tagetes tenifolia, this is also annual and branching in habitat. Then Tagetes lucida. It is a sweet-scented marigold. You remember this one? Sweet-scented marigold is Tagetes lucida. Then Tagetes minuta is Mexican marigold. This is Tagetes minuta. Then coming to important varieties. Here in marigold, the intraspecific hybrids are more common by crossing the two species, the French and marigold species. There have been more than hundreds of varieties. They are termed as intraspecific hybrids, mainly the red and gold hybrids. This is a group. Red and gold hybrids are the intraspecific hybrids. This is also a very important point. Under this group, the Nugget, Snowbolt, Red, Seven Star. These are the important hybrids, are the varieties. Comes under intraspecific hybrid, under the group Red and Gold hybrids. You remember this. This is frequently asked question. Then African marigold varieties like apricot, primrose. Then important variety like honeycomb, Pusa Narangi Genda, Pusa Basanti Genda. These are all very important. Under French marigold, rusty red, naughty, then flame, star of India, then harmony. These are all important ones. Coming to propagation, mainly propagated through seeds, but nowadays the farmers are following stem cutting, terminal tip cuttings for the propagation. So the hybrids or the improved varieties were mostly used in the stem tip cuttings, terminal tip cuttings. If you use the seeds, what will happen? It is a cross-pollinated. So the more heterozygous condition will be observed in the offspring. So we can't expect a similar yield or the similar growing pattern as like as parents. So seed propagation is only restricted for the varieties, not for the hybrids. Then coming to important cultural operations, the spacing will be 45 into 45 for the African type marigold, 30 into 30 for the French. This is correlated with the growing habitat. It grows small, so spacing will be small. Pinching is very important operation followed in the marigold to increase the yield in the marigold. Here we will remove the terminal portion of tips after 30 to 45 days after transplanting. These terminal tips also further we plant in the cocoa pits. So these terminal tips will be further we used for the planting material to plant in the other fields. Then here important pest will be aphids, red spider mite, leaf hoppers, and beetles and weevils. Here the red spider mite, aphids, sucking pest will be major pest. Then coming to diseases, wilt, stem rot, collar rot, leaf spot, these are all, and damping off in the nursery. Then flower bud rot, this is during the before harvest. If the rainy season is coincidence with the if the harvesting is coincidence with the rainy showers, the flower bud rot will be more. And wilt and rot also, the wilt and stem rot is also correlated with the rainy season. Then how to control these pests, we have to deal in detail. And coming to harvest and yield, here it will comes in 2.5 to 3 months after transplanting. Then regular picking is have been seen. A regular picking also improves the yield. How? After the flower reaches the maturity, if we pluck the flower, it won't divert seed photosynthesis to same flower. It will concentrate on other small buds. So the regular picking will improve the further development of small buds. So automatically the yield will increases. Here the fresh flowers are picked from the hand. It is easy to harvest. And further, we will see the some of the important varieties. This is African type marigold. You see, the flower size is very large. This is French one. You see the color difference, the color tinge, the brick red color tinge of French marigold. Then this is signata type marigold. This is lucida, sweet marigold. Minuta, the flowers are so minute. Then petula, this is erecta, this is tenifolia. These are all used in the garden for creating the flower beds. Then in marigold, we have two types of, in the marigold, we observe genetic male sterility, GMS, genetic male sterility. In GMS, we'll observe two type of condition. One is double flower type. Double flower type means here it won't concentrate on the flower organs. It will, the flower organs are modified as petals. So the male sterility will be observed in this doubled flower type by the distorted male organ. Here, the male sterility, what kind of male sterility is observed in marigold? Genetic male sterility, GMS. In GMS, we'll observe two conditions. One is doubled flower type, another one is apetalous type. What do you mean by doubled flower type means? Here the flower organ, the male flower organs are distorted. So it won't produce the viable pollens. That's only it will become male sterile. This is one condition. Then further, this is apetalous. Apetalous means it failed to produce the petals. It failed to produce the petals. This condition also leads to male sterility in marigold. You remember, this apetalous type of male sterility is exploited in marigold for the hybrid seed production. You remember this one. Apetalous type of genetic male sterility. Then some of the important breeders. Here with respect to marigold, Dr. S.P.S. Raghava. He is one of the prominent scientists working on the marigold. Then Vishnu Swarup. You remember Raghava, S.P.S. Raghava is associated with the marigold flower. This is very important. Then some of the important institutes working on marigold is IRI, IIHR, and other state agriculture universities. And some of the important companies working on this marigold is Indo-American Hybrid Seeds, Syngenta, and East and West Company. Then important IHR variety is Arka Bangara. Arka Bangara. Bangara means it is yellow in color, golden yellow in color. That's why the name is Arka Bangara. Then Pusa Arpita. Pusa Arpita from IRI. Pusa series from IRI. Pusa Narangi Genda. Then Pusa Basanti Genda. Why the prefix Pusa? Anyone can answer? Why the IRI Institute use the prefix like Pusa, Pusa series?
It's situated in Pusa, New Delhi.
Yeah. Nowadays, after the establishment of IRI New Delhi, they renamed as a Pusa campus. Before it was in Bihar, Pusa.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So in the remembrance of the that place where the first it was originated, they kept the Pusa. Then some of the important hybrids like from the East and West seed, Arrow Gold. This is not, they won't ask the private varieties in the exams, but for your information, Maximum Yellow. Then we'll deal with the important top points from the book chapter. Here, the marigold is quantitatively short day plant. You remember, these are very important points with respect to your competitive exam. I won't just say like stories. These are very important for your JRF, SRF, or any other competitive exams. For your NEET also, these are very important points. This is quantitatively short day plant. Means, what do you mean by quantitatively short day plant? It only flowers under short day condition. If it is exposed for the day neutral or long day, the yield going to decrease. This is the meaning of quantitative short day plant. Here observe, the family is Asteraceae. Clear?
Yes, sir.
In marigold, we observe 33 species, but commercially cultivated one are French and marigold. Here, the African marigold is diploid or tetraploid?
Diploid.
Yeah. Tetras erecti is diploid in condition. Petula, French marigold is tetraploid in nature. You kindly remember this one. And tenifolia also important. Tenifolia, lucida, and erecta, diploid in condition. Tetras petula, minuta, this is in tetraploid condition. 2x is equal to 22.
So French is tetraploid, but size is small compared than African. Why, sir?
These are all tetraploid. Generally, if you go for polyploidy breeding, if you treat any seeds or any propagating material, the generally what will happen, it will yield, the polyploidy material will yield the more flower size or more branching habitat. This is artificially induced ploidy change, polyploidy. But these are all natural species. This will occur, or this will be incorporated in their genome. If we induce artificially, we'll concentrate on inducing them to increase their flower size or to increase their flower yield. But these species don't concentrate on their increasing their flower size. Naturally, they mainly target on their propagating their species or propagating to increase their natural population in the nature. This is the only concept of a plant in this nature. It has to reproduce and make a stable population on the earth. That's why only these plants struggle to reproduce. This is the natural ploidy. This tetraploid is not created by us. This is the natural process. In spite of the tetraploid also, the flower size is very small in French marigold. This is also important one.
Yes, sir.
Yes. In India, this marigold was introduced by Portuguese. This is also one of the important point. Marigold was introduced by Portuguese. Mainly, this marigold is used for the carotenoid pigments. The principal carotenoid pigment present in this flower is xanthophyll, particularly lutein. You remember this lutein and xanthophyll. Xanthophyll is a group of pigment. Under this, the lutein is a particular pigment. It accounts 80 to 90%. Palmitic and myristic acid in the forms of esters of palmitic acid and myristic acid. They won't ask in-depth questions, but you remember xanthophyll, it's a group of pigments occurred in the marigold. Among them, particularly lutein is present up to 90% in the form of esters. In the form of esters. Then Tegetus petula, this is commercially used for the extraction of industrial dyes, mainly brown dyes. You remember, Tegetus petula is associated with the brown dyes. Dyes means color. This Tegetus is a good source of aniline. which varies with the flower color. That means the deep yellow colors contains the more halogen than the dark red colors. You remember, Tizatus species is rich source of halenine. Okay. Then tenifolia, sweet marigold, mainly used for the extraction of good quality essential oil, mainly used in the costly perfumes. Perfume industry is associated with Tizatus tenifolia. Then Tizatus signata also contains the essential oil. These two important species are associated with the perfume industry. Then this is also important topic, important point. Marigold is widely used as a trap crop at every 30th row in tomato in order to trap the Helicorpa armigera. Marigold is used as a trap crop at every 30th row in tomato in order to trap the Helicorpa armigera. Okay. Then Tizatus grandiflora. This flower concrete is used in the high-grade perfumery industry. Tizatus grandiflora, used in the high-grade perfume. It has the property of germicidal and microbial applications. Generally, all the essential oils, all the flower concretes, they have the property of germicidal or antimicrobial property. But you remember, this grandiflora is used for the extraction of flower concrete. Then this Tizatus lucida leaves and flowers are employed to perfume bath watering. Means these are all boiled in the watering to take the showers. Then this also act as repellent for the mosquitoes and nematodes. Nematodes, flies, another mosquito. Then this marigold petals commercially used as a feed additive in the poultry industry. This xanthophyll pigments, mainly this lutein, has gained an economic interest on account of their potentially improving the pigmentation in the broiler chicken, broiler skin, and the egg yolk, mainly used in the poultry to increase the pigmentation in broiler skin and the coloring of egg yolk. This is very important. Xanthophyll pigments, mainly lutein, used in the poultry industry, mainly to increase the color. Then the marigold varieties mainly used for the lutein extractions were Orange Double and Pusa Narangi Genda. Then the two private enterprises which works on the contract farming in marigold are A.V. Thomas Natural Products Limited and Agro Biochemical India for the pigment extraction. These are all mainly not asked in the question in the exams, but for your kind information, these are all the two private enterprises mainly deals with the contract farming in marigold for the extraction of pigments. Then this alpha tartinel, it's a sulfur compound present in the roots and tissues of marigold to kill the parasitic nematodes. This is very important. What is the compound responsible for a repellent for the nematode? Why they are used as a trap crop means this alpha tartinel, a sulfur compound, this is the chemical ingredient which mainly responsible for the repellent or for the killing of parasitic nematodes in marigold. How the essential oils are extracted? Mainly through steam distillation process. The immunity against cancer. The dietary lutein has the property anti-cancerous, or the immunity against the cancer. Once again. further with respect to spacing, for the French marigold, as it's the lesser space, 30 by 30, and the African marigold, 40 by 40. And the flower yield also, you can observe the difference. 20 to 22 tons per hectare, African marigold, and 12 to 15 tons per hectare, French marigold. With respect to breeding, it is self-incompatible, proto-andry, and genetic male sterility is observed. This is very important. Climax is the first F1 hybrid in marigold. This is a private variety. Climax is the first F1. Then intraspecific hybrids are common in marigold, mainly the red and gold hybrids. Nugget, Snowboard series are comes under gold and yellow flowers. Nugget series, Snowboard series comes under red and gold hybrids. Then we have discussed the distinctive male sterility system observed in the marigold, mainly apetaloid, petaloid, and gynoecious types. Generally, we'll observe apetaloid and double flower. Double flower only. These two comes, petaloid type and gynomonocious types. Petaloid means the sterile flower with no petals. All the floral organs turned into a filament-like structures known as apetaloid condition or apetaloid male sterility. Here, all the petals are deteriorated or deformed. All the floral organs are turned into a filament, as we observed in the picture. Petaloid male sterility means the attractive and distinct male sterile lines where the stamen replaced with the petals, leading to petaloid sterility. Here, the male flower organs are deformed into petals, leads to male sterility. Then gynomonocious type means the both the female and the hermaphrodite flowers of the same plant are turned into or replaced or deformed into petals. So here also the male sterility occurs. Here apetaloid male sterility is governed by a single recessive gene. This is very important with respect to commercial hybrid seed production. Here, the male sterility is very important for the hybrid seed production, and it is transferred through back crossing. This is also important. Any genotype or any specific character or any specific gene to be transferred, the back crossing is the only easiest way. These male sterility lines gives rise to normal sterile plants. These male sterile lines will generally give 1:1 ratio of normal plants and male sterile plants. During the hybrid seed production, we have to rogue out the normal plants. Means we have to uproot the normal plants. We have to only keep the male sterile lines. This is also important. 1:1 ratio of normal and sterile lines will produce the male sterile lines in marigold will produce 1:1 ratio of normal plants and sterile plants. During hybrid seed production, we have to rogue out the normal plants. In Kerala, the grafting is practiced in marigold in order to control the bacterial wilt diseases. Okay, grafting is associated in order to control the bacterial wilt disease in the Kerala. some of the important IRA variety, Pusa Narangi Genda, Basanti Genda, Pusa Bahar, then Pusa Arpita, Pusa Deep. These two are French marigold type. And this Pusa Bahar is African marigold. And these two are hybrids. From IHR, African marigold varieties like Arca Bangara 2, Arca Agni, all these are developed through cytoplasmic male sterility, vegetatively propagated. These are all vegetatively propagated. The cytoplasmic male sterility only exploited in vegetatively propagated plant species. Hence, these hybrids only propagated in vegetative only. If the farmers comes, they only give the terminal cuttings. They won't give the seeds. These are all the CMS cytoplasmic male sterility. Through this technique only, these hybrids are evolved. And for the French marigold, here Arca Pari, Arca Honey, these are all open pollinated varieties. Arca Pari and Arca Honey. What do you mean by photo insensitive? Anyone? Quick.
No effect on light.
Yes.
Means flowering.
The seasonality. Consider the marigold is only grown in the winter or only grown in the summer. It won't grow in the rainy season. This is like a like taboo. It won't grow in the other seasons. But now what they're doing, these marigold can be grown throughout the year. Means it won't affect the season. The seasonality will not be there for the cultivation of these varieties, Arca Pari and Arca Honey. Then Hisar Beauty is also important one. Hisar Beauty. Then Hima Gold from IHBT. What do you mean by IHBT? Can you expand? What do you mean by IHBT? IHBT Palampur. I'm giving the clue also. It's an institute. You don't know IHBT. IHBT is a very important premier institute which comes under CSIR. IHBT means Institute of Himalayan Bioresource Technology, located in Palampur. Where is Palampur? Where is the Palampur?
Himachal Pradesh.
Yes, it's located in Himachal Pradesh state. IHBT, it's a CSIR institute, very important. Himgold, it's a hybrid released from IHBT for the extraction of essential oil. Further, I will discuss some of the important points from my short notes. If it is any other unique or new points is there, I will spell out, or it will be like a revision type. Then this African marigold is also known as Rose of Indies. This is also an important one. Rose of Indies. Gia xanthin, xanthophyll, lutein. These are all the three important compounds. Gia xanthin, xanthophyll, lutein. Then mainly these French marigolds are used in the rockery garden, hanging basket, or window baskets. They are mainly used in creating the beds or rockery. Nugget is the triploid variety in marigold. You remember this one? Nugget is the triploid variety in marigold. Here, self-incompatibility is there, protoandry is there. So it is highly cross-pollinated. What is the seed rate, hybrid seed rate? Mainly 1 to 1.5 kg. Then one of the important variety under the species Tenifolia, Tegetus tenifolia, is golden gem. Golden gem. Climax was the first hybrid. Then Nugget was the triploid variety. It's an intraspecific. Intraspecific triploid variety. Developed at USA. Then can you give me some example for the green fillers? Anyone? Green fillers. What do you mean by green fillers? Green fillers means mainly they are the fillers used in the flower decoration. They are in green. That's it. The name itself indicates green fillers used in the flower decoration. Mainly cochia, gypsophila. These are all the green fillers. Have you heard Molucella? M-O-L-U-C-E-L-L-A. You have heard of it?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, this is also important green filler. Butterscotch is an important variety associated with which crop? Butterscotch, French marigold. Spider mite is the important pest. Flower bud rot is important disease. Then one of the frequent question asked in the competitive exam is, which among the following flower is not used in the Gajra? The option will be definitely marigold. Which among the following is not used in the preparation of Gajra? You know Gajra? Hair odorant. You know Gajra? In Kerala people or South people?
No.
Yeah.
Sir.
Yeah. Yes, tell me. Then any doubts or any queries or any points to add for this discussion? Yes?
No, sir.
Okay. Then I will show you one video on extraction of marigold oleoresin and lutein, how they going to extract in the commercial scale. This, you kindly watch this. Okay. Food grade and feed grade marigold lutein extraction. Visible, right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
This is the marigold flower nursery. If you mainly propagate it through seeds, the nursery will be prepared. Or if you go for the terminal stem cutting, we'll prepare in the protrace. This is how the ridges will be formed. In the commercial scale, they will go for the ridges. If you grow African type, the plant will be more tall and bushy. That's why the spacing is more here. And these people, the industry people or the enterprise people, they will deal like the buyback system. They will give all the technologies, since from the seeds, planting material, how to prepare the land, fertilizer, how to care for the plant, prevention measures like pesticide, fungicides, all the things they will tell. The only thing, they have to look after the plants. Then they need to harvest the flowers and give it to the industry people. After the harvesting, they will go for the processing. They will first dry in the natural sunlight under the polyols or other protected measures. Further, they will go into dry in the industrial equipments. After the drying, these flowers will be made into a fine pellets, tablets like. Then these tablets are the pellets used for the extraction of the pharmaceutical compounds like oleoresin, xanthophyll, lutein, zeaxanthin, or for the essential oil. This is like a complete commercial setup. For the extraction of these, we need a big industry only. These are all the facilities that we need for the extraction. For the essential oil extraction, we need only the steam distillation unit. But for the pharmaceutical compounds extraction, we need a complete industrial setup. This instrument, what you are seeing is HPLC. You know what do you mean by HPLC? High pressure liquid chromatography means in that liquid or in that aromatic air, what are all the components are present, it will be detected. This is the oleoresin, liquid-like form. After finishing, after the extraction, this is the final product. And these containers will be exported. This is the export packing material. These are all the natural substitutes. These are all very costly. Food grade oleoresins. Oleoresins is nothing but, you just remember, like, this is the color, food grade colors. Okay. Then any doubts, queries?
So this is recent video, no?
Yes.
This video is recent, na?
What?
Recent marks is there, means?
I didn't heard it properly.
Matlab recent video, na, sir?
Recent video?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, you see the how to extract oleoresin. This is a standard protocol, right?
Yes.
The procedure will be same. If the video was old or new one, the protocol will be same. This is industrial, complete industrial setup for the extraction of oleoresin or for the essential oil or for the any pharmaceutical component. This is the proper protocol they should follow. This is the general procedure. These are all the minimum industrial equipments they need. And these are all the minimum industrial procedure they have to follow. Okay. Then, any other doubts? I think we covered jasmine, right? Yes.
Yes, sir.
Okay, then we'll cover the what do you want to be in the next class? Which topic? Which concept? Can we discuss tuberose in the next class? Tuberose also we can expect.
Yes, sir.
Okay, in the next class we'll discuss on tuberose crop. Okay.
Okay,
then if it is a case, we'll close the meeting. Stop recording.